SSI makes shredders that are basically the same machine for a lot of different applications. And by changing cutters and other things, we can change what the machine is capable of doing. One of the things that we can alter, depending on what the application of the shredder is going to be used for, is the drive. In other words, how we're providing the torque to the shredder. A hydraulic shredder is where we take and put a hydraulic link between the electric motor and the shredder itself. The first step is that we have electric motors, which are the prime mover. They're the ones that generate the force for us. We have a coupling and we have a large hydraulic pump here. The hydraulic pump sends fluid up and over through these hydraulic hoses here to a hydraulic motor. The hydraulic motor is going through a single stage of planetary reduction just to get the speed down to the speed that we need for the shredder. And then the power flows into the shredder. It takes a while to stop an electric motor, reverse it, and then stop it again and bring it back forward again. So the hydraulics have very rapid reversals. So if the shredder encounters something that it can't process, it literally is a second and a half later, we're going the other direction. We're unloading that material. A second and a half later, we're back forward again. And in the space of 10 seconds, we've dealt with this object. It makes the machine very, very tolerant for whatever you put into it. And the particular type of pump and the particular type of hydraulic circuit that we use, it varies depending on what we're trying to do with the shredder. So this one is a closed loop. We have open loop. We have various pressure ratings on different components. The closed loop has oil flowing from the pump to the motor and right back to the pump in a little tight loop. And so the closed loop has a smaller footprint primarily because you can use a much smaller reservoir. The variable speed on the closed loop comes from the fact that we're using piston pumps, and it gives you a nice soft shift also, so that you're not just going along at top speed and then just slamming it to a stop and slamming back the other direction like you do with some of the open loops. It will just shift very smoothly from full forward to full reverse and back to full forward again. And so the performance of the shredder is also enhanced, and it ends up being a little bit more efficient. An open loop system is very simple. Suck the oil in, run it through a filter, run it through the motor, back again. Anybody can get a handle on how that works. Cost advantages of an open loop have to do with the maintenance, because the pumps are cheaper, you have less filtration and so forth. The power unit is large, but it's very simple. It actually doesn't matter to whoever's operating the shredder whether it's closed loop or open loop, and people make a big deal of this. There are some advantages that SSI's engineering group can take advantage of, open loop or closed loop. At the end of the day, what does the shredder want? We have to work backwards and figure out how to get that.